जय राधा माधवा कुंज बिहारी जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौरभक्त वृंद जय श्री गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौरा भक्त वृंद जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौरा भक्त वृंद Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare,
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna.
Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Jaya Prabhupada, Jaya Prabhupada, Prabhupada, Jaya Prabhupada. Prabhupada, 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 Jaya Prabhupada. Nittai Gaura Hari Ba, Hari Ba, Hari Ba, Gaura Hari Ba,
Go Premanande. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Narayanam Namaskrityam. Naram Chaiva Narottamam. Devim Sarasvatim Vyasam. Tato Jayam Udhirayat. Nasta praeshu abhadreshu nityan bhagavata sevaya bhagavati uttama shloke bhaktir bhavati naishtiki. Hare Krishna. Welcome everyone. Today we are reading from Srimad Bhagavatam, 10th canto, chapter 84, verse 31. I might need a book. If you could do with this, you can do all of them, yeah, of course. Yeah, so it's 31, 32, and 33. I'll do 31, and then we do 30. Let's say. Okay, I'll do 31. Sannikarshotramartyanam anadaranakaranam. Gangam hitva yatanyam bhas tatratyo yati shuddhaye. Translation. In this world, familiarity breeds contempt. For example, one who lives on the banks of the Ganges might travel to some other body of water to be purified. So you have also this saying in Sanskrit. So familiarity breeds contempt in Sanskrit is Sannikarsha. Sannikarsha means familiarity, proximity. Prabhupada translates proximity. So sannikarsha, here, atra, in this world, here, bring, so Sannikarsha brings anadharana. So anadharana is contempt. So Sannikarsha brings anadharana. Or, as it is put here, Sannikarsha is a karanam. Karanam means cause, yes. So Sannikarsha is a karanam of anadharana, of contempt. Is a, no, Sannikarsha is a cause for mortals, of contempt. Yeah? So Sannikarsha tra martyanam, literally martyanam is among the mortals, genitive plural. Of four mortals, among mortals, Sannikarsha, familiarity, is the karanam, is the cause of another, of contempt. And now he gives an example in the second part. What is the example? That Gangam hitwa yatanyan bhas tatratyo yati shuddhaye. That someone who lives by the Ganga, yeah, he hitwa, gives up. You know this word hitwa? Giving up.
But you know, it looks, this Sanskrit language looks very similar in languages where I know. In, like for example, with it, in Russian, little bit, and Lithuanian. I can understand a little bit Sanskrit and with no translate. It's very interesting for me when you can understand Sanskrit with no translator, you know. Little bit can, not perfect, not 100%, but little bit can understand. It's very interesting for me.
Where are you from?
Lithuania.
You're a Lithuanian speaker. You speak Lithuanian and Sanskrit and Russian.
And Russian and German.
And German.
And
yeah.
English.
Yes, because they call Indo, Sanskrit is an Indo-European language. Have you heard the concept of Indo-European? Have you heard of the word Indo-European?
Yeah.
So Indo-European is called the Indo-European family. So it's essentially the same language. They originate from the same language.
These people go in different places
and they move. They change it. Yeah. Just like in Europe, you have during the Roman period, they spread Latin. So Latin was the language of the learned and the language of law or the language of whatever, of religion also. And then through Latin, people developed their own way of speaking, a kind of form of Latin, a more simplified, what they call vulgar, or like a, you know, or expedient way of Latin, simplified way of Latin. And in this way, they develop language like Italian, French, Spanish, Portuguese. But essentially, they are basically very similar languages. They originate from the same. So similarly, like it's from Sanskrit, people, they traveled. Prabhupada says, the kings, especially in Europe, kings defeated by Parashuram, they moved to different parts of Europe. And that's how the other languages, Indo-European languages, Prabhupada says this Indo-European language, Indo-European stock, Prabhupada used to use the term, the Indo-European stock. So that's why they're so similar. Especially Lithuanian. Lithuanian is very similar to Sanskrit. In the, like, one of the most famous dictionary is Monier-William dictionary that I used at university. And you have explanation of the Sanskrit word, and then they give you the correspondent in Greek, in Latin, in Slavic language, and in Lithuanian, specifically. And Lithuanian is particularly close to Sanskrit. Yes. So that is the situation.
Thank you for the answer.
Yes. So the idea is this. The point is, Prabhupada was making this point with regard to languages, because languages, the language is considered the major indicator of a culture. You can understand the, you know, the most accurate or the most close or the most detailed way you can understand a culture over this of a place. You analyze different things. If you analyze a country, the culture, you can look at different things, what they eat, what they dress, or whatever. But the language is considered one of the most important factors. So Prabhupada would make this argument. Prabhupada would make this argument. He says, because, you know, these languages, Indo-European languages, they're very similar. Therefore, we originally come from the same culture. So this Krishna consciousness culture, or we call Vedic culture, is actually our original inherited culture. That was Prabhupada's argument. So taking up Krishna consciousness, or taking up the Vedic culture, that's what we're trying to do, means taking up our original culture. That was Prabhupada's argument.
But for people, it's very material.
Very much?
Material, so it's the reason why I need language, why I need Sanskrit and all these languages, because person is very material.
Interiority is spiritual. That was Prabhupada's main point. And why we should chant Hare Krishna. That this is spiritual sound vibration that is conveyed through language, through a Sanskrit language, which is spiritual. So there is such a thing as a spiritual language, a spiritual sound, of which material sound is just a perverted reflection. So we don't need to give up sound and language altogether. We need to give up material sound, material languages, and take up spiritual sound, the spiritual languages. Spiritual sound vibration.
I ask him because when my mom in clinical died, she told me what angels, like this creature, she not hear it, but she just understand, just feel it.
Oh yeah, that's also there.
What this person,
yeah, that is also
there. Want to say.
Yeah.
So it's
yeah.
This level, you don't need like words.
Yes.
Understand.
Yes. Yeah. Okay. Let's press on. Let's carry on.
Sorry.
That's okay. So the example given is this. Well, this is an example given in regard to familiarity with discontent. Now, in the second part of this verse, and the example is Gangam. Gangam hitwa yata ambha tatratya. Yati Shuddhaye, that a person that is Ganga, that is Tatratyaha, who lives near Ganga, he lives near the Ganga, which is considered the most sacred and holiest of river, but because of familiarity, he sees the Ganga every day, and familiarity breeds contempt, he thinks, Shuddhaye, I need to become purified, I need to purify myself. So, he hitwa, you know this word hitwa, yeah? Mukti hitwa anyata rupam swarupena vevastitihi. That mukti, definition of mukti, is hitwa anyata rupam. We need to give up all the other forms that we have, all our mental forms we have created. Hitwa anyata rupam swarupena vevastitihi. And we need to situate ourselves in our own swarupa, which is Krishna Nityadas. So a person, because of familiarity, lives near the Ganga, he sees the Ganga every day, he wants to become purified, and he says, no, I'm not going to, hitwa, he gives up the Ganga, and he maybe walks 10 miles, 20 miles. If he lives in the Ganga, by the Ganga, is in India, and there are many holy places in India, so then he thinks, okay, I'm going in this other place to purify myself, giving up the Ganga for the purpose of purification. So this is an example of familiarity breeding contempt. Yeah. Okay, let's do the next verse, which is 32 and 33. And you have 30, yeah, okay. Okay, maybe I read the first one myself still, and then the second one, the longer one, we do try to do together. Yasyanu bhuti kalena layot patya dinasya vai swato nyasmaccha gunato nakutashchana rishati. The Supreme Lord's awareness is never disturbed by time. No, actually, no. And now I read the next Sanskrit verse and we do that together, and then I read the translation, everything together. I think this might work well. So we'll do this together now, yeah? I think this Brahma Samhita. Yeah. Tam klesha karma paripaka guna pravahair.
Tam klesha karma paripaka guna pravahair.
avyahatanubhavamishvaram advitiyam pranadi bhisva vibhavai rupa guram anyo manyeta suryam iva mega imo paragai tam klesha karma paripaka guna pravahair avyahatanu bhavamishvaram advitiyam pranadi bhisva vibhavai rupa guram anyo manyeta suryam iva mega himo paragai tam klecha karma paripaka guna pravahair avyahatanu bhavamishvaram advitiyam pranadi bhisva vibhavai rupa guram anyo manyeta suryam iva mega himo paragai
Pranadi bhisva vibhavai rupa guram anyo.
manyeta suryam iva megha himo paragair. Okay, now I'll do the word for word of both of them. Yasya.
Yasya.
Whose?
Whose?
Anubhutihi.
Anubhutihi.
Awareness.
Awareness.
Kalena.
Kalena.
Caused by time.
Caused by time.
Laya.
Laya.
By the distraction.
By the distraction.
Utpatti.
Utpatti.
Creation.
Creation.
Adina.
Adina.
And so on.
And so on.
Asya.
Asya.
Of this.
Of this.
As of this universe.
Universe.
Vai.
Vai.
Indeed.
Indeed.
Swataha.
Swataha.
On its own.
On its own.
Anyasmat.
Anyasmat.
Due to some other agency.
Due to some other agency.
Cha,
cha,
or
gunataha,
in terms of its qualities.
Its qualities.
Na,
na,
not.
Not.
Kutashchana,
kutashchana,
for any reason.
For any reason.
Rishati,
rishati,
becomes disrupted.
Becomes
tam,
tam,
him.
Him.
Klesha,
klesha,
by material distress.
By material distress.
Karma,
karma,
material activities.
Paribhaka,
their consequences.
Consequences.
Guna,
guna,
of the modes of nature.
Nature.
Pravahai,
pravahai,
and by the constant flow.
Constant flow.
Anyahata,
anyahata,
unaffected.
Unaffected.
Anubhavam,
anubhavam,
whose consciousness.
Ishvaram,
the Supreme Controller.
Advitiyam,
who has no second.
Prana,
by the vital air.
Adibihi,
and other,
as in elements of material body.
Swa, his own.
Vibhavai,
expansions.
Upaguram,
disguised.
Anyaha,
someone else.
Manyeta,
consider.
Suryamiva,
like the sun.
Megha,
by clouds.
Hima,
snow.
Uparagahi,
and eclipses. Translation. The Supreme Lord's awareness is never disturbed by time, by the creation and destruction of the universe, by changes in its own qualities, or by anything else, whether self-caused or external. But although the consciousness of the Supreme, of the Personality of Godhead, who He is the Supreme One, without a second, is never affected by material distress, by the reactions of material work, or by the constant flow of nature's modes, ordinary persons nonetheless think that the Lord is covered by His own creation of prana and other material elements, just as one may think that the sun is covered by clouds, snow, or an eclipse. Please repeat after me. The Supreme Lord's awareness,
Supreme Lord's awareness,
is never disturbed, by time,
by the creation,
and destruction of the universe,
by changes,
in its own qualities,
or by anything else,
whether self-caused,
or external.
But although,
the consciousness of
this Personality of Godhead,
who is the Supreme One,
without a second,
is never affected by material
distress,
by the reactions of material work,
or by the constant flow
of materials of nature's modes.
Ordinary persons
nonetheless
think that the Lord
is covered by His own creation,
by his own
of prana and other material elements. Just as one may think that the sun is covered by clouds, snow or any eclipse. Purport: things of this world are inevitably destroyed by one means or another. Time itself causes the eventual decay of every created being. A fruit, for instance, which may grow ripe, but then must either rot or be eaten. Some things, like lightning, destroy themselves as soon as they are manifested, while others are destroyed suddenly by external agent, as a clay pot is by a hammer. Even in living bodies and other things whose existence continues for some time, there is a constant flux of various qualities that are destroyed and replaced by others. In contrast to all of this, the Supreme Personality of God's awareness is never disrupted by anything. Only out of ignorance could one imagine him to be an ordinary human being subject to material conditions. Mortal beings are covered by their entanglement in fruitive activities and their consequent happiness and distress. But the Supreme Lord cannot be covered by what are, in fact, his own expansions. Analogously, the immense sun is the source of the relatively insignificant phenomena of clouds, snow, and eclipses, and so it cannot be covered by them, though the ordinary observer may think that it is. Tam klesha karma paripaka guna prabahair anyahata nubhavamishvara madvitiyam pranadi bisvavibhavair upaguda manyo mannita suryam ivamigha imo paragair. The Supreme Lord's awareness is never disturbed by time, by the creation and destruction of the universe, by changes in its own qualities, or by anything else, whether self-caused or external. But although the consciousness of the Personality of Godhead, who is the Supreme One without a second, is never affected by material distress, by the reactions of material work, or by the constant flow of nature's modes, ordinary persons nonetheless think that the Lord is covered by his own creation of prana and other material elements, just as one may think that the sun is covered by clouds, snow, or an eclipse. Om Ajnana Timirandasya Gyananjana Shalakaya Chakshur Unmilitam Yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasari Gaura Bhaktavrinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna. So in the previous verse, it is explained that familiarity breeds contempt. And now here we see how familiarity breeds contempt. You see? The relation between? Please give him. Is the mic working?
No, it's fine. I mean, I thought before we move on to the next one. No,
but this is very important. We need to use the mic because, so, as I say every time I give class, I listen to the lectures from home, and it's very frustrating when there is interaction and I can't hear what they ask.
No, I thought I don't want to interrupt during the class, but I thought before we move on to next one, so I was just wondering what is, if I missed, maybe I may have missed it, but I'm just wondering what is the significance of the example given of Ganges and the body, you know, it says something about the body changing.
You're referring to the previous verse?
Previous verse, yeah, exactly.
What is the significance of that?
Exactly, yes, yeah, okay. That's what I want. Thank you. Thanks.
Yes, of course. Okay, so in the previous verse, it was explained that familiarity breeds contempt. As an example was given that someone who lives by the Ganges, he develops contempt for the Ganges due to familiarity, because if you live by the Ganges, you become familiar with the Ganges. Like with proximity, familiarity is generated. So if you live by the Ganges, you develop a sense of familiarity towards the Ganges. Yeah. Those, for example, who spent some time in Mayapur or lived in Mayapur, like I have the fortune to live in Mayapur sometimes, and we were there all the time, and we were familiar. There was a sense of familiarity because you just walk out, and 5 minutes you go to the Ganges, and you start doing all kinds of things. You know, play games and do this and do that. It's there, and you see other people do a kind of things by the Ganges. You can see there is a sense of familiarity that is developed. So as an example, so someone who lives by the Ganges, develops familiarity with the Ganges, he thinks, I need to get purified, but because of his familiarity with the Ganges, he thinks, he can actually dive in the Ganges and get purified by the Ganges, which is the most pure or the purest of river. He says, no, I have to go somewhere else, travel 10, 20 miles, 100 miles to find another holy place, another holy river to purify myself. So this is an example of familiarity. Now, that was the verse was familiar. Now, that verse was spoken previously because now we see this. This is another example of familiarity. What is the example of familiarity here? The Supreme Lord? Can you see familiarity here? Can you see? Can you spot where is the familiarity developed here? The contempt, no. Where is the contempt due to familiarity here in this verse we just read together?
Is it because we identify the law to be us, to be like us, but in actuality is completely different?
Exactly. Atmanan manyate jagat. Atmanan manyate jagat. We have this tendency in the material world, conditioned souls, to think Atmanam, the whole universe, the Jagat, the whole universe is Atmanam. They think, manyate, people think, conditioned souls think that Atmanam, manyate, Jagat, that the whole world is like myself. Atmanam means self, yeah? Atma means self, soul, reflex is the reflexive pronoun. So due to this mentality, become familiar, and therefore we think that Krishna is like us. Is an ordinary person like us. This is the general common mistake people are making. Basically, yeah, it may be a bit better, a bit more smart and that, but fundamentally is like us. So this is the thing. But this verse is explaining details. In details, how Krishna is not like us. Yeah? So the sages are saying that, for example, Krishna's Anubhuti, yeah, Anubhuti hi, yasya, Anubhuti, yeah, he is Krishna's awareness, Anubhuti, yeah, is never disturbed. Krishna's awareness, let me just finish the concept and then you can ask. Krishna's awareness is never disturbed to begin with, unlike conditioned souls whose awareness tends to be disturbed. Conditioned souls tend to be disturbed. Especially in Kali Yuga, conditioned souls tend to be disturbed. As the beginning of the Bhagavad explains, the other sages when they're talking to try to find a remedy for the conditioned souls of Kali Yuga, what do they say? How do they describe the conditioned souls in Kali Yuga? Manda sumanda matayo, manda bhagya upadruta. They are very unfortunate, they are manda. Manda means?
Less intelligent,
yes. Matayor. And they are upadruta. They are?
Disturbed.
Yes, Matayor? Always disturbed. Not just sometime. Always disturbed. And you can see, just walk out of the street. You walk around, just do a field work. Ethnographic field research. Just go out in Honokso Street, stand there, and you know, walk around a little bit slowly without, so they don't notice you, and just look at the people walking by and look at their minds. You can see people's mind. You can see they're completely, they're totally disturbed. They're not walking around in samadhi, very absorbed and peace. No, you can see they're like this all the time, completely disturbed by hundreds of thousands of sounds simultaneously, you know, assaulting their senses and smells and this like that. So we are upadruta, we are always disturbed, but Krishna is not disturbed, his consciousness is not disturbed. And then very nicely the sages, they show, they list what causes disturbance. First item that causes disturbance is kala, time. Because ultimately, if you're not disturbed by anything, we are disturbed by everything. But let's say you are not disturbed by anything in this world. You manage to find a peaceful corner on this planet where you can, you know, be peaceful. Eventually, being in the material world and being in a material body, your peace will be disturbed by time. How will peace be disturbed by time? How will your peace be disturbed by time? Huh? Sorry? Yes, you'll die. Old age and death will get you, and you can't. There is no hiding from that. Yeah, it will be destroyed by time. When Krishna showed Arjuna the universal form, and Arjuna became completely bewildered and shocked and scared. He says, "But who are you? Who are you, Krishna? I thought you were such and such, but now this is completely." And Krishna's answer is, "Kalosmi, lokakshayakrit. I am time." Krishna says, "Lokakshayakrit. I am the destroyer of the world." So destruction is quite a disturbance. When you see destruction in place, it's disturbing. It's not, usually you don't associate the term destruction with peacefulness, and scenes of destruction are disturbing scenes. Yeah, so like that. So Krishna is not disturbed by time. By creation, by destruction, like, you know, as you know, the material world is creating destructive periodically. But as it's explained in the Chatushloki Bhagavatam, Krishna says, aham eva asam eva agre. Krishna says, in the Chatushloki Bhagavatam, Krishna says, before the creation, I was there. Nanya satasat param. And after the destruction of this world, before the creation I was there, and after the destruction of this material world, I will still be there. Krishna is not disturbed, but he's not affected by the creation and destruction of this material world. So like that. So Krishna is never disturbed by time, by the creation and destruction of the universe, by changes in his own quality, you know. Gunas, Krishna is not under the gunas. We are disturbed by constant changes. The gunas are really acting upon the conditioned souls. Therefore, we change because the gunas change. Yeah, we observe. Things are always changing because the gunas are interacting in different ways. Therefore, they are constant. But Krishna is not under the modes of material nature. Krishna is beyond the modes of material nature. Therefore, is not affected by the modes of material nature. So here, these verses show what Krishna is not affected by, and simultaneously shows what we are under. Yeah, it shows the condition. Yeah, it shows what is Krishna not conditioned by, and it shows what are the living entity conditioned by in material existence. So this situation, we are under the gunas, we are under time. Yeah, we are under the influence of creation and destruction. This is our predicament here in the material world. Or by anything else, whether self-cause or external. But although the consciousness of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, who is the Supreme without a second, Advitiya, is never affected by material distress, yeah? Krishna is never affected by, what's the word for material distress here? Klesha, yeah? Klesha, yeah? You know this word klesha, yeah? Which are the klesha? Krishna is never affected by klesha, but we are affected by klesha. Which klesha are we affected by? Can you give Mataji the mic, please? This is very important. Which klesha we are under? Full of anxiety, as Prabhupada says.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
I know of three different ones.
Yes.
So, adhyatmika klesha.
Yes.
Misery is caused by the body and mind.
Yeah.
Adibhautika klesha. Misery is caused by other living entities.
Yeah.
And adidaivika klesha. Misery is caused by the demigods, like natural disturbances. And
yes. So, this is our situation. We are under this klesha. But Krishna is not under the klesha. And we also can overcome klesha by the process of devotional service, as it is described in the beginning of devotional of the Nectar of Devotion, that devotional service brings certain benefit. And the first benefit is, what is the first benefit of engaging in devotional service? Yes, please.
Kleshagni.
Kleshagni, yes. Kleshagni means?
Freedom from material distresses.
Free material distress. And then in Rupa Goswami, in the Nectar, in Upadesham, in Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu, explains what are the klesha, where are these klesha coming from. Yeah? These klesha are coming from different type of karma that we are subjected to. He described that the karma that is in the seed form, bija, forgot the Sanskrit now, different level, though that is manifested, that is not yet manifested. Anybody knows the Sanskrit of this? He remembers? Yes. Kutam, yes. Papam, bijam, kutam, yes. Yes. Different stages of karma. In other words, the different stages of karmic reaction. Some of them manifesting, some of us there in the seed, some are yet manifested. That's all it is. Our suffering is due to this. There's nothing outside of it. Our suffering is due to our karma, which manifested in different stages. And the process of devotional service, the first thing that does, kleshagni, it relieves us of the suffering caused by our karma. By all the different pape bhyo, Krishna calls it pape bhyo. When Krishna says at the end of the Bhagavad Gita, sarva dharmam parityaja, give up all other process, all other dharma, all other process, give it up, give it up completely, parityaja, give it up completely, mam ekam sharanam vraja, and go to me only for sharanam, for shelter. Don't go here and there, don't do 50-50. You know, sometimes people do investment. So one strategy in investment, that you don't invest everything in one thing. Because if that investment doesn't work, then you lose all the money. So they recommend you, what's the word? Diversify. You diversify your investment. So if one investment doesn't work, the other might, you don't lose all your pot. But Krishna is not advising diversification of investment. Krishna says, invest everything in me. Put all your money, put everything in me. Sharanam, go ekam, go to me alone for your investment. Aham, and if you do that, aham tvam sarva pape bhyo moksha ishami. I will free you from all the pap. And the pap, we just described, they manifested the different karmic reaction. Those are the... That's why it's klesha agni. So it's not, Krishna is not affected by material distress that we are. He's not affected by reaction of his karma. Not by the modes of nature. But, then the sages say, ordinary person think that Krishna is a conditioned soul by us, like us. Just like the example give, they think that the sun is covered by snow, yeah? Hima, you know this word Hima, yeah? Hima, as in Himalaya. Yeah, Himalaya is the place of snow. Place of ice or something, or snow. So people think, because it's snowing, therefore, you know, when it's heavy snow, you don't see the sun. It's not sun in heavy snow. oh, see, the sun is covered by the snow. No, sun is there. If you take a plane, as we all do nowadays, you take off, you go through the clouds, above the clouds, and it's always sunny up there. So like that, these are the points of these verses. Any questions on this? Can't see the time, it's covered by... What time is it? 8:30. Any questions on these points? On projection, or the problem of projecting? Atmanamatyajaka means projecting, in Western terms. We project our conscious onto other. We think everybody else is like us. Therefore, we think that Krishna is also like us. Yes, Mataji.
Towards the end of the first paragraph of the purport,
yeah,
there's a sentence or a couple of sentences. Just scroll down a little bit. Yeah, there he says that... even in living bodies and other things whose existence continues for some time, there is a constant flux of various qualities that are destroyed and replaced by others. Could you explain that a little bit, please?
In the purport, yeah?
Yeah. Last sentence of the first paragraph.
Last sentence of?
Of the first paragraph.
Even in living bodies, okay. Some things like lightning destroy themselves as soon as they are manifested, while others are destroyed suddenly by external agents. As a clay pot is by a hammer, even in living bodies and other things whose existence continues for some time, there is a constant flux of various qualities that are destroyed and replaced by others. This has got to do with the body regenerated itself. You know this idea that every 7 years the body your body is practically new. Maybe it's referring to that. There's a constant changes and regeneration, even of cells, and also the qualities. Fluctuation of quality of the modes that fluctuate. Flux of various qualities, and the body itself is in constant fluctuation. There's a replacement, refueling, and a cycle. Things are going out, things are coming in. So there is I think it's refers to that. Any other points? By the way, today is Bhima Ekadashi, also known as Pandava Ekadashi. It's the most important Ekadashi of the year, where devotees attempt to fast. Nirjal is called also Nirjal Ekadashi, because some will try to also fast from water. They won't drink any water either. It's considered a very auspicious moment to fast, make spiritual advancement, to absorb ourselves in Krishna consciousness. The main point of Ekadashi, of fasting, or not drinking water, just talking to a devotee. The main point is that we become absorbed in Krishna consciousness. We increase chanting and hearing and remembrance of Krishna. If not drinking water will make us unconscious, then it's better if we drink water. But if you get avoid drinking water and still be Krishna conscious, can still chant and hear and do your service, then that's very nice. Anything else? Jai Srimad Bhagavatam ki jai. Srila Prabhupada ki jai. Samaveta Bhakta Vrinda ki jai. Gopimanande. One note on this thing that we... Samaveta Bhaktavrinda Kijaya, yeah? It's Samaveta, yeah? The assembled devotee. Samaveta means assembled. It's not Samaveda. We know it's nice to glorify the Samaveda. There's nothing wrong with glorification of Samaveda. But we're not glorifying the Samaveda like the Rig or some. It's Samaveta, yeah? We glorify the assembled devotee. Samaveta means assembled. Thank you, Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
To Jagat Palana Prabhu for the class.
So we have some Sankirtan results from yesterday. In Radha's boutique, 5 books were distributed for 160 Lakshmi points. And in Govinda's restaurant, 292 transactions for 2,440 Lakshmi points. And in Closet Krishna, 9 medium books were distributed for 146 Lakshmi points. Srila Prabhupada, Sankirtan Yagya Kira. We don't have any book scores, as far as I can see from the hand. Those are the ones I've just read. So we'll say the prayer. Is there, are there any volunteers to serve prasadam, those who are taking prasadam? Is anyone brave enough to take prasadam? Okay, thank you. And anyone can clean the temple room afterwards? Anyone can volunteer for that? Thank you very much. Dear Sri Sri Radha Landanishvara, Jagannath Baladev and Subhadra, Sri Sri Gauranathai, and Giri Govardhan, we offer our most respectful obeisances unto you. In a mood of deep gratitude and appreciation, we request your causeless mercy upon us. For your pleasure, if you so desire. We wish to erect a holy place of your transcendental pastimes that will attract unlimited souls to your service and fulfill the vision of your pure devotee, Srila Prabhupada for London. Please enable us to cooperate together in order to satisfy you in this way. We are surrendered servants humbly beg. New temple for their lordships. Ki jai. Okay, thank you very much, everyone. Please help in the prasadam chain. Hare Krishna. Thank you.